Hi, in this video, we are gonna set up the custom post type. So after defining your content and how it works, I'm gonna expect that you already have an idea for what type of post type do you need or do you want to set up. In my case here with this demo website, I want to create a post type per level. So I have introduction and I also have level one. The main reason is I think it's related to the counting that I'm doing inside. We're gonna for sure get bumped into that in the next video. But I defined, once you have defined how you think this will work, you will for sure need discover what certain post type do you need to build. When setting up a post type in Jet Engine, so there's two types. So there's two type of post type in Jet Engine. It's either you use the default post type, which will inherit the post functionality, or you create your custom content types. So it will be very specific, different, and it will have its own database table, and then it can also be customized for what is only necessary in terms of field. Unlike the custom post type, is it will mimic to what's available by default in the WordPress post. So just a note on that one. So whichever works for you, sometimes custom content type is necessary, but usually I just use or set it up with the post type, custom post type that's available in Jet Engine. So once you have set up yours, it will be listed in here. Now let's open the intro, the very first post type that I have set up. Okay, so in here, when you example, if it's your first time creating one, you click this add new button and then you define your post type in here. I'm gonna open mine so that you can copy what I have set up. So of course you provide the post type name and the slug. There should be no space, but you can use underscore or hyphen letters as well. And then you can also enable this if you want, but usually I just leave that off. And then on the labels, let's see if I have defined that. Nope. Under advanced settings, I've set this to public. And then so these are the ones that are on. Feel free to copy that. I think I usually leave most of this default, whatever is turned on by default by Jet Engine. And then I also enable has archive. So you need to enable that. And then I have defined the menu position and then the menu icon and what type of feature that I want to inherit or use for this custom post type. Right now, I just have the title and editor, which is, I think, the default. But you can grab the featured image as well, the authors, and stuff if you need that. You can even put certain meta fields for this type of post type, but in my case, I haven't done that. So once you have added your post type here, if this is your new, after that, you just click the add post type on the right side, the blue button, and that should be added. Now, in my case, I have two post types. So let's also open the level one. It should be exactly similar. I haven't added anything special with this one. Regarding the menu position, as you can see, I have 94 here, and then I also have 93. To be honest, I don't really have spent a lot of time on the menu positioning in WordPress and stuff. I just try to put it side by side. So I usually start with a large number and then 90 and then use that. So 93, 94 and so on. So that's how I set up the custom post type for this website. So thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.